hello and welcome, my friend. And then I am planning to give you information that where I can purchase this tester, this car OBD scanner and faulty scanner. And now I have visited in ebay.com, that shopping place, and I have purchased this Autel scanner, what is in here. And let's look, and price is about 35 US dollars, and this is that kind of product, and I purchased that product because there is good ratings, and especially there is quite high this percentage, 98% positive feedback. And there is this my scanner, and now I think that is this really same package what I had. I remember that I had maybe, it looks like just that it is Autel. Yes, there is some another Autels too, but I believe that it is that one. It cost about 35 US dollars and in euros. Okay, and then here is this my product, and then we can look at what there is inside. And there is inside first this good manual, but we don't need that. And then there is some software if we have issues or we like to install that in our computer. But this is the most best one. This is the scanner unit, and now there is a situation that we don't need any battery, even that there is battery cover. This works using this car's electricity and car's battery. And what we need to do is first we need to connect this our cable in here, in that slot, in that way. And okay, I check that. Is this right? Yes, a little bit deeper, and then I fasten these bolts, and then we need to go to check our car, my car. And now I'm so lucky that I have a Toyota Corolla car, where is this error warning light, this engine warning light on. And we can go to look that what is wrong in this my car. And let's go to do that next. Okay, and now I am inside in this my car, and then I turn off this my car. There's my key. I have key, and I insert that in here, and then we can see that what is wrong in my car. And now when we look at our engine area, I need to then start this my car, because then I can see that what. Because now I have this warning light on, and then I start my car. Okay, and now this my warning light is there on, look. And then I need to scan that what is wrong. And also this my engine is running really badly. And now I need to insert this my new tool. What is in here? This my scanner. And we have that part, what I need to then connect in this little bit down area. And then we look how I open a little bit more, but we can see a little bit more. But there's one place in here where I can insert, yes, in there. There is this scanner, and then I think that I need a little bit better light, that I can see. Now I have extra light in here, and there is this my scanner, and there is this my tool, and now I hook in that my scanner in that this is OBD port, and we can find that, so that there is this my car's door in here, and there is this where we open our car bonnet, and just when we look in here, there is this connector, and now I need to connect that part in there, and if we have Toyota car, this works really easily in Toyota way. But if you have any another car, you might have issues, and in the same time, this my machine start to work. Good. Now it is working. Good. And then we can look that little bit better, so that I take this my device in here, and then I there's some rust, and now when we are in that position, and then my electricity is on, I believe that now I can do this first scanning, and now I insert that enter button, there's actually instructions, enter menu, and then is diagnostic in here, and I need to enter again, and we go, and now this my scanner is scanning my car's computer, what is by the way in that hand glove box behind of that box in there, and then it says that here is previously stored data, now I should to enter yes, and now it reads my car's computer, and now it says that I have 7 codes. Okay, read codes, stored codes, and again always that, and now it press key, and now it says that there is manufacturing codes. Okay, I have Toyota, and I need to choose this my, there is also Dodge, look, and Chrysler, Ford, GM, and then we go to Toyota. And I use these arrows in here. Interesting. Smart Suzuki. Toyota, yes. And now I need to enter, then enter again. And there is first code. P300. Okay, and there is 7 codes. And then when I like to scan that, I insert that in here. Second, okay, or maybe these arrows. Second is 301, and then next one 303, and then okay P1300 igniter circuit malfunction, interesting, and then again, and then P1305 Celica. Okay, interesting. And then igniter circuit malfunction number P1300. Okay. And then next P, and this is the final one. Okay. And there are so many issues. Okay. And this is generic, and then also this Toyota's code. Excellent. Okay. And the brand is Autel. And then when I like to erase this data, I insert in here that ESC is like back, and then back, and there is code erase codes. And then I choose enter. And erase trouble codes, are you sure? Yes, I am, and again enter. And now it is erasing my, press any erase done, everything is fine. Okay, and then if I go to back, and now it says that my codes should be okay, but let's test then that I go read codes again and enter, and now it's stored codes, and now it reads no codes, excellent. Okay, and now when we look out this my car, next I start this my engine, and now there is situation that I have issues in my car, and there should be soon situation that there is faulty codes again. But this is, but it is not then this scanner's issue, because my cars, there is now issue in my engine, and I am planning to repair that. But let's look what happens when I start this my car again in here. Okay, now codes are away. Look, excellent. No codes in there. Engine is running badly. Soon there should be codes, because engine, there is issue in these electric spark plugs and ignition coils. Okay, and then I check that can I read codes when engine is running. Okay, interesting. But codes are away. But engine is running really badly. Okay. But that tells to myself that this scanner works really well. And then when I like to take that scanner away, final step is to insert. We insert our light. Is that I take this my connector away. Okay, thank you. Thank you. And now this my job is done, and of course, thank you for watching, and have a nice day to you.